Dear students, welcome to Mathematics Online classes. In the last class, we have derived a first particular function here, that is integration of 1 by x square minus a square. Then remaining 5, I asked you to solve. I hope all of you did it well. Some of you sent me through WhatsApp also, fine. Now, we are going to solve problem number 2 onwards, that is to derive integral of 1 by a square minus x square into dx is equal to 1 by 2a into log of mod of a minus xy, sorry, it is a plus xy, a minus x plus c. Easy it is. We have 1 by a square minus x square into dx. Denominator you observe, denominator is in the form of a square minus b square. A square minus b square can be written as a minus b into a plus b. Okay, this is integral of 1 divided by a minus x into a plus x into dx. Now, multiply by 2a and dividing by 2a. A minus x into a plus x into dx. 1 by 2a is a constant multiple. You write it out of the integral. Means we have written. Now that 2a I will split. How to split that 2a? If I split that 2a, it will be, means I want to write that 2a as a plus x and a minus x. Okay, very easy it is. You write this as a plus x plus of a minus x. You can observe plus x minus x get cancels out, a plus a become 2a divided by a minus x into a plus x. This dx will be as it is. 1 by 2a into integral of, here let me write it as sum of two functions. First one is a plus x by a minus x into a plus x plus of, second one is a minus x by a minus x into a plus x. You see here a plus x get cancel, a minus x get cancel. We have 1 by 2a into integral of, this is 1 by a minus x and this one is 1 by a plus x. Whole integral is with respect to x. Okay. Now, can we integrate it? Very easily we can integrate it. It is in the form of 1 by x. What is integral of 1 by x? 1 by x integral is log x. As it is a linear function, we can use the form f of ax plus b. Integrating the function, we have log of a minus x. We have to be careful here, dividing by coefficient of x. What is coefficient of x? That is minus 1. Right, minus 1. Plus of log of, we can put modulus also here, log of a minus x, here also log of a plus x divided by coefficient of x. What is coefficient of x? Plus 1. Even if you put that, no changes at all. 1 by 2a into, now this is minus log of mod of a minus x, this is plus log of mod of a plus x plus. You can observe this is in the form of log m minus log n, where this is log m and this one is log n. We have this formula as log of m by n. This is equal to 1 by 2a into log of a plus x by a minus x plus c. Okay. With this, now we have derived the second particular function. That formula you need to remember, that is integral of 1 divided by a square minus x square with respect to x is equal to 1 by 2a into log of mod of a plus x by a minus x plus c. Yes, with this second one completed, now we will move on to the third one. Now, particular function paradigm. What is that? To derive. Integral of 1 by a square plus x square with respect to x is equal to 1 by a into tan inverse of x by a plus c. Here you see, this can't be integrated as we did for first two particular functions. We need to go with substituting trigonometric functions here. We have 1 by a square plus x square into dx as the function to integrate. Then what we will substitute here? We will substitute x is equal to, suppose we substitute x is equal to a sin theta here, this can't be integrated. Means to proceed to the next step, there will be difficult. That's why what we do, x is equal to a tan theta, we will substitute. Substituting x is equal to a tan theta, you see, this become a square tan square theta. A square is common, 1 plus tan square theta. 1 plus tan square theta equal to, we have the standard formula. So, just think this much and substitute the trigonometric functions. Okay, x is equal to a tan theta, differentiating the function with respect to theta. Here you see, x is equal to a tan theta, we will substitute. Now, we are converting this whole problem to the variable, means in terms of the variable theta. Now, what happens to the dx? Differentiating the function with respect to theta, we have dx by d theta is equal to a into differentiation of tan theta is a secant square theta. We have dx is equal to a secant square theta into d theta. In place of this dx, we should substitute a times a secant square theta into d theta. Now, coming to the integral, 1 by a square plus x square means a square tan square theta into dx is a secant square theta into d theta. Integral of a secant square theta into d theta is the numerator, and what about the denominator? Denominator, you take a square common, it will be 1 plus tan square theta. One time you cancel this a. Then we can use the formula, SSLC formula, trigonometric. We know that 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. Now, substituting in the integral, here only one a is there in the denominator. Anyhow, it is a constant multiple. You write it out of the integral. 1 by a into integral of secant square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta is nothing but secant square theta by secant square theta into d theta. This get cancels out. We have 1 by a into integration of 1 with respect to theta. We know that integration of 1 with respect to x is x. In the same way, integration of 1 with respect to theta is theta. 1 by a into theta, integration completed, plus c. What is theta? Theta we can separate from the substitution part. X is equal to a tan theta. We have x is equal to a tan theta. Now, I have to separate for theta, you know. Take this x to the left hand side. X by a is equal to tan theta. Then, taking tan inverse on both sides, we have tan inverse of x by a is equal to theta. Okay. In place of theta, you substitute tan inverse of x by a. This is equal to 1 by a into tan inverse of x by a plus c. Okay. With this, third one completed. Now, we will move on to the fourth one. Fourth particular function, it is given to derive. We are going to derive now integral of 1 by square root of a square minus x square with respect to x is equal to sine inverse of x by a plus c.
Okay,
we have the integral 1 by square root of a square minus x square into dx.
Now what to substitute here? If we substitute it, x is equal to a sin theta, you observe a sin theta x is equal to a square sin square theta, it will be a square will be common from these two terms, it becomes 1 minus sin square theta. 1 minus sin square theta equal to, we have the formula as cos square theta, square and square root get cancelled. It is very easy to proceed. So here what you do, you substitute x is equal to a sin theta. Then what will be dx equal to? To get the dx, you differentiate the function with respect to theta. Differentiating the function with respect to theta, we have dx by d theta is equal to a as it is, differentiation of sin theta with respect to theta is cos theta. Now dx is equal to a cos theta into d theta, integral of 1 by square root of a square minus x square is a square into sin square theta, a square into sin square theta, which is multiplied with dx is nothing but a cos theta into d theta, integral of numerator a cos theta into d theta, you write. What about the denominator? Denominator is square root of a square is common, take it out, 1 minus of sin square theta. Then this is integral of a cos theta divided by square and square root get cancelled for this a. A can be written out of the square root, a into square root of what is 1 minus sin square theta equal to? We know the formula, sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Then if you send this sin square theta to the right side, this become cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta. Now you see, here we have 1 minus sin square theta, that can be replaced as a cos square theta into this d theta will be as it is, a get cancels out. This is equal to integral of, in the same way here you observe, here square is there, square and square root get cancels. We have cos theta by cos theta into theta, d theta, cos theta get cancels out, integration of 1 with respect to theta. As we did in the previous derivation, integration of 1 with respect to theta is theta, integration completed, put plus c. But what is theta? We can't keep the answer as a theta. We should take it back to the variable he has given. Variable is given in terms of x. We need to keep this answer in terms of x. Theta is the variable that what we have taken for just for the purpose of derivation. Okay. Now what is theta here? This theta can be separated from the substitution part. We are substituting x is equal to a sin theta. Now you separate for that. X is equal to a sin theta is there. This can be written as x by a is equal to sin theta. Taking inverse on both sides, we have sin inverse of x by a is equal to theta. Then this is sin inverse of x by a plus c. What is this? This is one of the important derivation, that is integral of 1 divided by square root of a square minus x square with respect to x is equal to sin inverse of x by a plus c. Okay. With this fourth derivation completed, we will go to the fifth derivation now. Fifth derivation is that integration of, let us write that to derive integral of 1 by square root of x square minus a square with respect to x is equal to log of mod of x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c. We are going to derive this. Here you see, we have 1 by square root of x square minus a square with respect to x. We should think of substituting the trigonometric function. Which trigonometric function to substitute here? If I substitute x is equal to a sin theta, a square common, this become sin square theta minus 1. Sin square theta minus 1 equal to, we don't have the formula. Next, cos square theta also, same thing happens. If you substitute tan theta, x is equal to a tan theta, if you substitute a square common, it becomes tan square theta minus 1. Tan square theta minus 1 equal to, we don't have the formula. But if you substitute x is equal to a secant theta, what happens, you see? Using this identity, 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. Send this 1 to the right hand side. This becomes tan square theta is equal to secant square theta minus 1. You see, if I substitute x is equal to a secant theta, this will be the form secant square theta minus 1, can be replaced as tan square theta. Very easy, okay? You substitute x is equal to a secant theta, okay? X is equal to a secant theta, we are substituting, differentiating the function with respect to theta. We have dx by d theta is equal to a into, what is differentiation of secant theta with respect to theta? This is secant theta into tan. We have dx is equal to a secant theta into tan theta into d theta. Now, coming to the integral of 1 by square root of x means a secant theta. This will be a square secant square theta minus 1. What is dx theta? Dx theta is a secant theta into tan theta into d theta. Fine. Sorry, this is a secant square theta minus a square it is. Okay. Integral of numerator you write as it is a secant theta into tan theta divided by, what happens to the denominator? A square is common. Take this out. A square into, we have secant square theta minus 1. Into d theta will be there, that one you keep as it is. Now, integral of numerator, a secant theta into tan theta, keep this as it is, divided by denominator, square and square root get cancels for this a, this will be outside a, into square root of secant square theta minus 1. Using this formula, secant square theta minus 1 is nothing but tan square theta. Square and square root get cancels out. Now we have here a also get cancels, integration of secant theta into tan theta divided by tan theta into d theta. Tan theta get cancelled. We have integration of secant theta into d theta. What is integration of secant theta? We have the integration of secant theta as log of mod of secant theta plus tan theta plus c. Next, what are these secant theta and tan theta? For that, we will come to the substitution. See, we have x is equal to a times secant theta. With this, I can write x by a is equal to secant theta. You see, secant theta equal to, I will substitute x by a. Now, what about the tan theta? To get the tan theta, I will come to the formula 1 plus tan square theta equal to secant square theta. We have tan square theta is equal to secant square theta minus 1. Then tan square theta equal to secant square theta is nothing but secant theta is x by a, secant square will be x square by a square minus 1. This is x square minus a square by a square. What is this? This is tan square theta is equal to, this is tan square theta equal. Then what is tan theta? Tan theta is equal to square root of x square minus a square whole divided by square root of a square, taking square root. Denominator square root get cancelled. We have tan theta is equal to square root of x square minus a square divided by a. Now, I will substitute this tan theta equal to and secant theta equal to in this answer. This is log of mod of secant theta means x by a plus of tan theta means square root of x square minus a square divided by a plus c. instead of writing this as c, let me take this as c1. Now this is log of mod of LCM is a here, numerator will be x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c1. Constant it is c1 I am taking. You see, it is in the form of log of m by n. What is log of m by n equal to formula? Log of m by n is equal to log m minus log n, where log m is x plus square root of x square minus a square and n is a. With this formula I can write this answer as log of mod of x plus square root of x square minus a square, x square minus a square, next minus of log a plus c1. Okay, this is equal to log of mod of x plus square root of x square minus a square. You see, log a is a constant value. It can be like log 1, log 2, a log of any real number, again a real number only. For a real number, if you add another one constant, another one real number, that will be another one constant only. This minus log a plus c1 together, we will write another one constant, that is c. So final result is integration of 1 by square root of x square minus a square with respect to x is log of mod of x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c. Okay, this is about a fifth derivation. We will take the next one, that is sixth one now. Sixth one says here to derive integration of 1 by square root of a square plus x square or x square plus a square, both are same, into dx is equal to log of mod of x plus square root of x square plus a square plus c. Okay, here what to substitute? We will substitute the trigonometric function in this integral, 1 divided by square root of a square plus x square into dx equal to, we will substitute here x is equal to a tan theta. If we substitute x is equal to a tan theta, this will be a square tan square theta, a square common, 1 plus tan square theta. 1 plus tan square theta equal to, we have it as secant square theta, very easy to integrate. Okay, differentiating the function with respect to theta, we have dx by d theta is equal to a into secant square theta, because differentiation of tan theta is secant square theta. Dx is equal to a secant square theta into d theta. Now it is integral of 1 by square root of a square plus x square, means a square tan square theta. Dx is a times secant square theta into d theta. This is integral of a secant square theta into d theta divided by here square root of a square common, 1 plus tan square theta. Next it is integral of a times a secant square theta divided by square and square root get cancelled for this first one. This become a into square root of 1 plus tan square theta into d theta. Okay, a get cancels out. We have integral of secant square theta divided by square root of 1 plus tan square theta equal to formula secant square theta. We have used it in the previous derivation, secant square. Denominator you observe, square and square root get cancels out. Now this is integral of secant square theta divided by denominator is square and square root get cancelled. We have secant theta into d theta. Once again you see, secant theta get cancels out. We have integration of secant theta with respect to theta. What is integration of secant theta with respect to theta? That is log of mod of secant theta plus tan theta plus, let me write it as c1, some constant c1. Now substituting secant theta and tan theta. You see here, with the substitution, x is equal to a into tan theta, we have tan theta is equal to x by a. Now what will be secant theta? For secant theta, we will use the formula 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. This become 1 plus x square by a square, which is equal to secant square theta. This is a square plus x square by a square, which is equal to secant square theta. Taking square root on both sides, we have square root of a square plus x square divided by square root of a square, which is equal to square root of secant square theta. Here also root of square root get cancelled. We have square root of a square plus x square by a, which is equal to secant theta. Now this is log of mod of secant theta is square root of a square plus x square, can be written as x square plus a square by a plus of x by a tan theta equal to plus c1. Now log of mod of numerator can be written as x plus square root of x square plus a square, LCM is a here, okay, plus c1. Again we have the formula log m by n. Log m by n equal to log m minus log n, means it is log of mod of x plus square root of x square plus a square minus log a plus c1. Minus log a plus c1 is another one constant. One constant is getting added with another one constant, we will get third constant, that is log of mod of x plus square root of x square plus a square plus, this is the sixth property we have derived. Practice all these derivations once again. Thank you.